Hello everyone, today we'll learn how to record software simulations. On the start page of the application, click Record Software Simulation. Then you'll see a blue rectangle and a crosshair in the middle of it, and the Record Software Simulation project dialog with many options. The blue rectangle indicates the capture area, and the actions happening inside of it will be recorded. You can resize the rectangle and move it to anywhere on the screen. You can also change the capture area size from the size section in this dialog. Just enter values in the size box or select one from the presets. Besides, to record the entire screen, click Full Screen. Click Lock to Application to make the blue rectangle follow the target software. If the recorded application doesn't stay still while recording, you should select this option. Here's where you can change the lock mode. You can let the application fit into the blue rectangle or vice versa. Select the target application to lock. Next, click the audio button to turn the audio recording mode on. You can record both audio from microphone and system audio. Drag the volume scale to change the recording volume. Since the recorded audio file is placed onto different slices, you should record narration when the recording is finished. This makes it easier for you to edit the audio. When you click this settings button, you can choose to show or hide the capture area and the recording toolbar. You can also calibrate the audio input and have many settings on the recording settings dialog. However, they will be discussed in other video tutorials. Now take a look at the recording toolbar. This section shows some project statistics which vary during the recording. The mode will be video if you scroll the mouse or carry drag and drop action. Otherwise, ActivePresenter will switch back to the slide mode. Frame shows the current frame number of the recording project, and dropped is the number of missed frames of the recorded video. You can know how long the recording project is in the duration section. If you record audio, the audio section lets you know the recording sound level. Besides, these three buttons are to pause, stop, and discard the recording. You can also press Ctrl and N to stop recording. Now I'll move this toolbar outside the capture area so that it won't be recorded. After on the preparation and settings, click the record button to start. On the actions that you perform with the target software will be recorded. I'm demonstrating how to insert a smart chart in Microsoft PowerPoint. When you finish, press Ctrl and N. And you will have a project with slices containing the steps that you've carried like this. You are free to edit the auto-generated annotations. You can also change their position if they are not in the right place. The tag of the annotation is editable. You can also increase or decrease the clickable area size. Now let's preview the output. As you can see, hidden messages appear telling how users are doing. Clicking on the right position will take them to the next step of the procedure. Finally, export the project to HTML5 when you are done the editing. It's the ultimate output for the simulations that require user interactions. Select the operation mode to export. You can export the project to SCOM or XAPI if needed. That's how to record software simulations with ActivePresenter 7. Stay tuned for the upcoming video tutorials, and thank you for watching.